Okay friends, now let us see the new topic, random variable. Connecting the outcomes of a random experiment with real value is known as a random variable. Random variable in the sense, so far we are doing random experiment, right? So in random experiment, we are going to get a sample space. To every sample space, if we can connect a real value, that particular point is known as, that particular connection is known as a random variable, friends. For example, mathematically, it can be seen as random variable is x here. This is random variable. There is a functional mapping, sample space is tending to R. That means we are assigning a real value to the sample space. That is nothing but a random variable. Okay, fine. So random variable are two types, friends. One is discrete random variable and continuous random variable. In discrete random variable, when we distribute these values to corresponding probabilities, we will get probability mass function, friends. And this is called discrete distribution. And this probability mass function always defines at the probability of at integers, friends. At particular integers only, if p of x equal to 3, p of x equal to 4, at that particular integers only, the probability is defined. At particular decimal values, the probability is not defined. Okay, next. Continuous random variable here, we denote it with small f of x, and the probability density function is small f of x, friends. So here, through continuous random variable, we will get density function. Through discrete random variable, we get mass function. Okay. So this is continuous distribution in continuous because of continuous random variable, and this probability density function always defines the probability between the points. That means now here decimal points, probability density function defines the probabilities at decimal points. Okay, always remember these two points, friends. Probability of mass function never defines the probability at decimal places and decimal points, and probability density function does not exist at equal sign. Okay. So I hope you understand. Just remember these basics. Now let us see what is mean and variance. Okay, now let us see very important formulas, mean and variance. Okay, so what do you mean by mean? Mean is nothing but the average. Okay, mean is denoted by mu, friends. Remember, mean is denoted by mu. Mean is also called as expectation of the random variable or x bar. In that case also you can represent. So what do you mean by expectation? Expectation is nothing but mean. For there are two types of random variables, right? Discrete random variable and continuous random variable. For discrete random variable, the expectation is sigma x equal to 0 to n x into p of x. Okay. Next, expectation of x formula for in continuous random variable is integration minus infinity to infinity x into f of x dx. Right, so here we perform integration. Always remember, when x is not there, integral minus infinity to infinity f of x dx value is always equal to 1. When here x is also not there, sigma 0 to 1 n p of x equal to always 1, friends. So these formulas are very important. We often use in the problems in order to find the k value, which is constant in any random variable. Okay, next, variance. Variance is nothing but the square of the standard deviation, or we can represent variance as sigma x in this way also. Okay, root over variance is nothing but standard deviation. Okay, variance of x formula is general formula for variance of x is mean square value minus square of the mean. This is the general value, general formula for variance. In the sense, expectation of x square of the random variable minus expectation of random variable whole square. In the sense, how can we get this value, friends? By keeping x square here, that's all. By keeping x square, we will get square of the mean, friends. Mean square value, friends. Mean square value minus square of the mean. We will get this mean value and we will apply the square. We will delete that from this value. Then we will get the variance value. Fine. So when we do this root over condition, then we will get the standard deviation. Now for discrete random variable, the formula is sigma 0 to n x square p of x. This mean square value, friends. Mean square value, how do we calculate? What did I tell you? If we keep square value here, we will get mean square value minus sigma 0 to n x into p of x whole square. Square of the mean is discrete random variable. And for variance of x in continuous random variable, integral minus infinity to infinity x square f of x dx minus integral minus infinity to infinity x f of x dx whole square. Right? So, basing on these, we will do problems. Now, let us see the properties of mean and variance of a random variable. So, next one, friends. Properties of mean. If x is a random variable and a is a constant, then expectation of ax is nothing but, this is a constant, friends, 5, 3, 4, anything, that value comes out a into expectation of x. Next one, if x and y are random variables, next, expectation of x plus y or expectation of x minus y. That means if we add any two random variables or any or subtract any two random variables and we apply the expectation, then we will get like this: expectation of x plus expectation of y or expectation of x minus expectation of y. Same symbol comes, right? Remember. Next one. If x and y are independent random variables, if and only if x and y into x, expectation of x and y is equal to expectation of x into expectation of y. We have already discussed the independent event side. In the same way, if random variables are independent, expectation of x, y equal to expectation of x into expectation of y. Fine. Next, if y equals to ax plus b, a, b are constants, then expectation of y is equal to a into expectation of x plus b. Here, expectation of ax plus b. So, expectation of ax plus expectation of b. Yes or no? So, a comes out, a into expectation of x plus. For b, it is constant. So, constant only comes because expectation of a constant is always a constant, friends. Okay. Expectation of 5, 5. Expectation of 7, 7. That's right. That's what. Next, expectation of x is nothing but same. This comes out. Expectation of x. Fine. So these are the important properties of mean. Now let us discuss the properties of variance. Now let us see the properties of variance. Okay. If x is a random variable and a is a constant, that means 2, 3, 4, any number, then variance of ax is nothing but a square into variance of x, friends. In expectation only a comes, but in variance a square comes out, right? So square and variance. Okay, if x and y are independent random variables, then v of x plus r minus y is v of x plus v of y. That's all. Whenever minus is also there, but still x only will come in variance. Okay, remember that. If a and b are constants, x and y are independent random variables, variance of ax minus by is nothing but variance of ax minus comes no, plus only will come according to this property. So plus variance of by. Variance of ax in the sense a square into vx, b variance of by in the sense b square into vy, according to first rule. In the same way, variance of x by a minus y by b, 1 by a square into variance of x minus comes means here plus will come, variance of 1 by b square into variance of y, right? Next, variance of constant is always 0. Next property, variance of ax plus b equals to a square into variance of x. These are the important properties, friends. Always remember that variance is always non-negative. It is a positive only, positive value only. Variance is always non-negative, right? So, these are the important properties. Let us see the problems on random variables.